It's nearly impossible to say who might have been the first Eastern philosopher. Some say it was Zoroaster, but there is no scholarly consensus on when he lived exactly. As far as reliable dates are concerned, the earliest Eastern philosophers that we know of were the Saptarishi, or Seven Rishis, or what we in the West might call the Seven Sages. The names of the Saptarishi vary across different texts, but we will cover the most commonly mentioned names over subsequent episodes. The Saptarishi lived during the early Vedic period in ancient India, which is generally dated from around 1500 BCE to 800 or maybe even 500 BCE. It was during this time that ancient India saw the emergence of philosophical ideas within the broader framework of the Vedas, a collection of sacred texts. While the Vedas primarily focus on ritualistic and religious aspects, they contain philosophical speculations as well. The early Vedic period did not have individual philosophers in the modern sense, but it laid the foundation for philosophical inquiries and contributed to the development of various philosophical schools in later periods. During this time, several important philosophical ideas and concepts were explored, particularly in the later portions of the Rigveda, known as the Upanishads. The Upanishads contain reflections on the nature of reality, the self, and the ultimate truths. Some of the prominent ideas and figures associated with the early Vedic philosophy include Rishis. The Rishis were the seers and sages who composed the hymns of the Rigveda. While they were primarily concerned with ritualistic practices and the worship of deities, they also contemplated philosophical questions about the nature of existence. Brahman. The concept of Brahman emerged during the early Vedic period. Brahman is an abstract, supreme, and all-pervading reality that underlies and sustains the universe. It is often associated with the divine or cosmic power. Atman. Atman refers to the individual self or soul. In the Upanishads, there is an exploration of the relationship between Atman and Brahman, with the idea that the individual self is fundamentally connected to the universal self. Karma. The concept of karma, the law of cause and effect, was also present in early Vedic philosophy. It suggests that a person's actions have consequences, which may affect their present life or future rebirths. Samsara. Samsara refers to the cycle of birth, death, and rebirth. The idea of reincarnation or transmigration of the soul was a part of early Vedic thought, with the belief that individuals go through multiple lives until they break free from the cycle of samsara. While these ideas were not systematically developed by individual philosophers during the early Vedic period, they laid the groundwork for later philosophical schools such as Vedanta, which further explored and elaborated upon these concepts.